Hello everyone, in this video I will show you how to create tools in GeoGebra. And we will do this solving the following example. The first task here, we need to create a tool signed area in GeoGebra. And the second task, we will use this tool to find some examples and to show that this property indeed works. So first of all, where you can create tools? Only in the application which is installed on your computer. You know that if you go to GeoGebra website, here the possibility to use online application. If you press here start calculator, here that you'll have online application where it's not possible to create tools. To make it possible, you go to application downloads. And here you download GeoGebra Classic 6 or 5 version and install on your computer. After this, you have possibility to create tools. So, and why do we need sometimes to create tools? Tools will help us to avoid repetitions in our work. So if you have to do the same thing for several times in your file, then it's easier to create a tool and then just using a tool to do what we need. So let's start solving this task. First, we need to create a tool sign area with the input objects, 3 arbitrary points. To create a tool, the first thing that you must do to create input objects and an output object. So in our case, input objects are 3 arbitrary points, so we take the tool point and we just put 3 arbitrary points, doesn't matter where. So let's say these are A, B, and C. And also we need to create an output object, and an output object will be sine area of triangle ABC. And to calculate sine area, we need only the points A, B, C and their coordinates, right? So we know that sine area is a half of a cross product of AB and AC in this case. So this is what we're going to calculate. So let's denote sine area. Let's say S, A, B, C. This is equal to, and here let's calculate the cross product. The cross product of AB and AC is the x-coordinate of AB, which is xb minus xa. So let's write it xb minus xa times the y-coordinate of AC, which is y-coordinate of C minus y-coordinate of A, and minus the product of x-coordinate of AC times y-coordinate of AB. So x coordinate of AC is xc minus xa times the y coordinate of AB, which is y of B minus y of A, and everything we divide by 2. So here we have the cross product calculated. If we now change the position of points, you see that we change the cross product. For example, let's say it's minus 9. Okay, and now let's create a tool. We go to menu tools, and here we have create new tool. Press it, and we have here output objects, input objects, and name of the icon. So let's start. Output object will be our sine area, number S, A, B, C, right? Input objects will be 3 points A, B, and C. GeoGebra already chosen for us these 3 points. Remember that the order is important. If we change the order, then this will be A, C, B, right? So let's leave it as A, B, C. And name of the icon, let's just name this area, sine area, for example, and press finish. New tool created successfully, and we see a new tool here. So now using this tool, we can find sine area of any triangle. For example, let's press it and we need to choose 3 arbitrary points. Let's choose, for example, A, C, B in different order. So you see the assigned area has been calculated here. Or you can take the tool and put some arbitrary points and you see sign area again is here. Okay, let me delete these points now. So the first task is completed. Now let's move to the second one. We need to show the additivity formula, and we have to consider three different examples for the point D on the segment AB, outside the segment AB, closer to B and closer to A. So let me maybe just make it more clear. So this is a triangle that we study, right? And we also need the line AB. And we take a point D, let's take it first on a segment. AB. And next we will calculate SADC and SDBC. Let's do this using our tool. So first SADC, so we choose ADC in the order that we need, and we see the answer is minus 4. Let me just, to make it more clear, let me rename this. So this is SADC. So this is minus 4, and next we need SDBC. So DBC. And you see the answer is minus 5 here. Let me also rename it. So SDBC. Okay, and what is A? SABC. So let's find it. Let's say some S, which is the right hand side, right? So right hand side is equal to SADC plus SDBC. Enter. You see it's minus 9, and SABC is also minus 9. So indeed, in our case, the property works. If we move this point D, you see that the sign areas will be different, but the sum of them stays the same. And also we need to make point D outside the segment AB closer to A. So let's now move to this point D outside the segment AB closer to A. So move it to this side. And you see that again, sine areas of these triangles are different, but the sum is still minus 9. And also we move it outside, closer to B, so to that side, you see again that sine areas, these are some new numbers, but sum is still minus 9. So that's all for this video. I'm Anna Tomskova. Thanks for listening.